This video will review central causes of sudden vision loss. Its objectives are to help you understand the blood supply to the eye and the brain, discover the clinical approach to evaluating central vision loss, and review a few critical cases of sudden vision loss due to central origins. We hope that these cases will set you up to succeed in the future. The visual pathway is shown in the image to the right. As you know, it starts with the eyes and then extends posteriorly with the optic nerves. In this prechiasmal location, the vision input in the pathway is from one eye alone, and thus visual fields that are localized to one eye are likely anterior to the chiasm. In the chiasm, we all know that fibers from the left and right eyes cross, and then the visual pathways are mixed, going posteriorly. The optic tracts come out of the chiasm and take the information from each eye to the lateral geniculate body. The optic radiations then take the information to the occipital cortex. Thus, visual fields can help you identify lesions along the visual pathway. This is an important examination tool that you must keep in the back of your mind when evaluating a patient who you may suspect has central causes of vision loss. Shown here is the anterior circulation of the brain and that which is responsible for supplying the eye. The internal carotid artery is shown at the bottom as the ICA. The ICA extends up into the brain and then gives off a branch called the ophthalmic artery, which is abbreviated as OPHA. The OPHA extends into the orbit and then gives a branch called the central retinal artery. That is abbreviated CRA in this image. A compromise of the vascular supply in this area will often lead to unilateral, transient, or permanent vision loss, depending on how long the vision and blood supply is compromised. Blood supply of the posterior visual pathway is shown in this image. As you know, this starts with the vertebral arteries, which then fuse to make the basilar artery. The basilar artery then gives off the posterior cerebral artery, abbreviated as PCA in the image to the right. Both the left and right PCA can be seen in this image. Compromise of the vascular supply here will lead to problems in the occipital lobe. And the occipital lobe is the primary and secondary visual cortex, as denoted by V1 and V2. Evaluating patients with sudden vision loss involves using all of our basic examination tools. Of course, because there is vision loss, we must start with an eye examination. This should include direct ophthalmoscopy to evaluate the fundus, as shown in the image to the right. Confrontation visual field testing is critical. As we know, neurological deficits will cause specific loss of visual field, which will help us localize where a lesion might be. Neurological testing can be helpful if there are other symptoms associated with the vision loss. Finally, brain imaging can also help inform next steps for a patient. So let's turn to some cases. A 67-year-old man is brought to the emergency department by his daughter. He was bumping into cabinets in his kitchen, noted that the room was spinning, and could not locate the car in the driveway, despite it being to the right of the front door. The triage nurse noticed that he skipped questions on the intake forms, and you review that these are primarily on the right side of the page. Your examination shows his visual acuity to be 20 over 20 in each eye. The anterior aspect of the eye by pen light examination is unremarkable, as is the posterior fundus. However, your visual field testing shows that both eyes have decreased sensitivity in the right visual field. Shown here is the visual field of the left eye in panel A and the visual field of the right eye in panel B. The white area shows areas that he can see, and the black area shows areas that he cannot. This is a homonymous hemianopia, and this helps you localize the lesion to a posterior part of the visual pathway in the left side of the brain. An MRI T2 weighted image does show an infarction in the occipital lobe as outlined by the arrows. The reason for his dizziness is likely that this also affected the cerebellum and his balance. So this is a stroke causing vision loss. Case two is a 76-year-old man who presents to the emergency department after experiencing a sudden blackening of vision in his left eye. It lasted 5 minutes and then resolved. He did not cover one eye or the other to see if it was truly unilateral, but is pretty sure. His examination is unremarkable, with visual acuity that you measure at 20 over 25 in each eye. The anterior part of the eye is unremarkable, and the fundoscopic examination is also unremarkable. Of note, he does have a history of hypertension and dyslipidemia. Given these findings and the transient loss of vision, you start to think that this must be, again, a vascular event. Now, it's difficult to understand whether this is in the anterior or posterior aspect of the visual pathway. If it's in the anterior, then it will truly be left-sided. If it is in the posterior aspect, then it will be left visual field. One must try to help a patient differentiate between a left-sided visual field deficit and a left eye problem. As we know, the anatomy is quite different. In this case, a full stroke workup was initiated, and this showed occlusion of the carotid artery at the bifurcation of the common carotid into the internal carotid artery, where the arrow is, and the external carotid artery to the left. This occlusion likely through an embolus that entered the ophthalmic artery and caused a transient loss of perfusion to the left eye for approximately 5 minutes and then cleared. This is a transient ischemic attack due to carotid stenosis, and this patient needs a full workup by the stroke team to ascertain his risk for further events that may cause permanent damage.
Finally, an 81-year-old man presented to the emergency department with sudden, painless loss of vision in the left eye that spread over his complete visual field over a 15-minute time frame. Examination in the emergency department documented visual acuities of 20 over 40 in the right eye and hand motions in the left eye. An afferent pupillary defect was also noted. When completing the examination on this patient with a direct ophthalmoscope and examining the retina, one may see the optic nerve to the left and a whitened retina centrally with an orange-red spot. That orange-red spot represents the fovea, and it is called a cherry red spot. The vasculature may look thready with lack of perfusion of some of the vessels. This indicates ischemia to the retina and is related to a central retinal artery occlusion. This occurs with atrial fibrillation, carotid stenosis, and left-right vascular shunts that may allow an embolus to travel to the carotid artery, the ophthalmic artery, and then lodge in the central retinal artery. It may also occur with inflammatory diseases, especially in the older population, such as giant cell arteritis. This causes small and medium vessel vasculitis and can lead to occlusion of the vasculature. In these cases, if it is suspected, erythrocyte sedimentation rate and C-reactive protein is important to order to see if it is elevated. If it is, prompt initiation with steroid therapy is critical to decrease the inflammation, not just in this eye, but in the fellow eye, which could suffer vision loss. This brings us to the conclusion of this presentation. We hope that it informs your next approach to a patient with sudden vision loss.